at the Idol Home Show, and as many of you know, I tore my muscle here a few years ago, and because of that, I accidentally started walking on the outside of my foot without even realising. In turn, I lost all the muscles on the inside of my foot, and then tore my hamstring and put my knee out of place. So I know some of you are going, oh yeah, I did that too. So I went to the physio, and the physio told me to stand with one foot in the middle where it says walking, put my hands on a chair just to psychologically balance, and stand on one leg with your leg in front. Now, as you move up and down really, really slowly, you want your knee to be going outwards. You don't want it to going in like that, because that's not so good and you fall over. So just move up and down like this really slowly. Now, the reason it's good is not only does it strengthen all the muscles around the knee area, but also the hip and the ankle. Now, when you are walking, hopefully it will make you walk with all of the muscles of your feet, because it forces you to have to use all of the muscles of your hands. So when you hit the floor and you're walking normally, hopefully you'll be less likely to twist ankles and knees. It's also a really good thing, not just for people who've had injuries, but also for runners before you go for a run, because obviously when you are running, you want to be able to hit the ground without twisting ankles. Of course, it is good to do before sport because it warms up all of your muscles, gets all of your blood circulation going as well, which is really, really nice. And if you ever want to get the resistance bands, I get the strong ones that we sell here, exclusively at the Idol Home Show. And it's really good to just sit down in the middle, turn to the side, and make sure you are in the middle, because remember, it's a little bit much. Sit in the middle, and I like to just wrap around my leg and just stretch like this. Now, as your leg goes back, it pushes you back a little bit, so you have to use your core, but also you're stretching all the muscles in the back of your hamstring. And the reason physios use something quite similar is because it doesn't put any pressure at all on your knees or your joints. And remember in my last video, you can then turn it into an exercise and replace a cross trainer, which will also tone your arm, because you're using the weight of your leg, get some weight. And if you ever want to make it more difficult, press the auto button, because the auto button's got three programs that go fast, slow, by itself, so that will make it work even harder. Good luck!